Our humble puds are going up against the glamour of the Italians, so we need some help pimping them up from some of Britain's top dessert makers. And here they are, a new breed of British patissiers, bakers, chocolatiers and ice cream makers, and their incredible creations.
Look at this, Jamie. Mate, this is heaven. It's all pure magic.
We're going up against the Italians in five categories. Chocolate. Hot dessert. Cake. Frozen dessert. And a wild card.
These guys are the magicians of the dessert world. Mate, this is heaven. Look at this.
Each chef has come up with their own modern take on our most loved puddings.
Thank you, everyone. Artisans, bakers, patissiers, ice cream makers. National pride is at stake here.
Look at that.
It's the king of lemon meringue pies. Lemon meringue, people think America, really. But I've been doing some research and I've found recipes going back to the 1700s.
Have you?
So I thought, why not reclaim it for the English?
Yes.
For Queen and Country.
Oh, yeah.
And crown it.
I think that's amazing. It's a showstopper.
Right, it's got dark pork and Stilton ice cream.
That is amazing. Your brain's thinking, ice cream, Stilton? It'll never work. It's classically British.
Mini little meringues. And you could put, like, lemon curd in the middle. So you could have them as, like, little lollipops. And then that's edible gold.
Oh, yeah.
Meringue and just crush it up into the buttercream. And then use that to ice the cake with. You've got the flavour of the strawberry and the sponge. But then you make, like, a raspberry coulis to go on top.
I love eating mess, but bite-sized little cupcake.
We need a classic British tart.
OK.
Something a little bit different.
What the hell is that?
It's all the flavours and textures of a Bakewell tart, but transported into something new. And there's something else. Take a pipette, get the cherry liqueur, just smash it in.
Did you inject? Yes, injected.
What does that smell of?
Almonds.
Beautiful. Bakewell tart.
Got a smaller spoon? Jimmy, just go for it.
After tasting their magical creations, we've asked three dessert makers to come to Italy with us. Pastry genius, Will Torrent, cake goddess, Gemma Wilson, and frozen fancy man, Charlie Harry Francis. Now it's time to put the next part of our plan into action.
What is that? It's a set for Ghost, the movie.
Are you ready to meet your challengers?
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Charlie Francis and David Jones. Hi, David.
How are you guys? Charlie, how are you doing?
Gino, nice to meet you.
So, Charlie first, what's your area of expertise?
So my company's called Lick Me, I'm Delicious, and we make liquid nitrogen...
Sorry?
Lick Me, I'm Delicious.
Oh, I've got a plate of pasta for you to use for your company.
OK, good.
Linguine la puttanesca, that will work beautifully.
Tell us about the tongue today, it's unbelievable. Right.
So we make liquid nitrogen ice cream at events using our portable liquid nitrogen ice cream parlour, but today... We have... Oh, that's a good move, isn't it? I like that. Today, we have the world's first liquid nitrogen ice cream pottery machine.
OK.
The world first.
I can guarantee you no-one's ever tried to do this before.
OK, are you going to try on me?
You'll have a go.
So
anyway.
How did you get into the ice cream making in the first place?
So I grew up on an ice cream farm in West Wales. My mother's an ice cream maker. It's all like right. you have strawberry cows and the black and white ones are the mint chocolate chip cows. That's how it works.
Okay, all right.
Yeah. Ice cream farm. And I wanted a way of being able to mix ice cream with anything that I could and make sort of basically any flavour instantly. So that's what I do. I make any flavour you want, as well as that. A bit of ice cream pottery on the side.
Oh,
wow,
right.
That's
and
nice.
Davis,
well, I'm a potter. I've been a potter for about 40 years, always had a pottery studio, so I usually work with clay, but ice cream is so much nicer.
Is it?
Is it?
Oh, absolutely brilliant, yeah.
How did you two get this thing going?
We always disagree on this. I think it was David's fault.
Well, David was searching on the internet for the website. He lick wanted something under, else. Yeah, lick me on what is it called?
Delicious.
So he went on the website for his own pleasure, and he found him, which he was completely
strange. Okay, that's the fiction bit. Can you now tell us the truth?
So, well, we were at a party. Yeah. We hadn't been drinking.
Yeah. So it's sober.
It's unusual for this man. I can tell you that.
Wow.
And I said to David, could we throw a liquid nitrogen ice cream pot, do you reckon? He said yes. Yeah. So that's why it's his fault.
Then we went down to my studio.
That's what you ask people when you're at a party, usually?
Well, it's a good opener,
isn't it? Yeah, all right, cool.
OK, so what is your challenge for Gino, to be clear?
So we are challenging Gino to, in under a minute, throw an ice cream pot on the potter's wheel.
It's called throwing, but to do it.
To make one.
But
to make
are you going to show me how to do, though?
Of course yeah. You will.
Oh, OK, yeah. All right.
How do you feel about it?
How do I feel? I don't know, but this looks quite romantic.
Yeah.
It reminds me of the movie.
Yeah.
Is this something we can do together?
Yeah. Were they naked, though? Huh? But they were naked, weren't
no,
they?
No, he just had the top off. But we can arrange that.
Wow. How does it work, you guys? Show us.
So we're using a liquid nitrogen injection system here. Oh, sorry, yes. Before
you
we do that,
to watch.
Bit of
you
safety. Can... Goggles on, everybody.
Goggles on.
It's all about safety first. So we're using liquid nitrogen, which is -193. It's perfectly safe to eat, but you don't want to get it in your eyes or in your head. You wear
okay,
a top
wait,
hat.
I need a okay. photograph of us all looking like
this. Brilliant. It was at this point we realised.
See?
On you want to go as well, don't what? You? You want to go as well.
Oh, God, I'd love to go. I used to work at the Science Museum and I worked with liquid nitrogen a lot.
Did you?
Yeah, I did, yeah. Yeah. You can really make things explode with liquid nitrogen.
This is the only cookery show where you actually find people like these coming on the show to show you stuff like
it's
that.
It's brilliant, really. Isn't it? It's
yeah, it's
really
got
cool.
a little bit cold. So what we're just doing, we're getting the ice cream, we're freezing it basically instantly using liquid nitrogen.
And it's still edible when you do that.
It's perfect edible, it's delicious.
Nitrogen yeah, makes up 70% of our atmosphere, so we're perfectly attuned
right,
to it.
Right, lovely.
Don't shut off. You still work at the Science Museum, Gina. I don't talk like that either.
Right. Well, okay. Do you want to watch, you've got to watch David? Oh, yeah. Because he's going to okay. show you how to use the wheel. Oh,
so what I'm doing here is I'm scooping it into a mould, which I'll then hand to David, and he'll put that into the wheel, and then we'll start, hopefully...
How cool is that?
Amazing.
Ice cream pottery.
This is cool. Now, have you got sorry, especially attuned hands?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah, really good. No finger.
I will help you out with
anymore.
The soundtrack. Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh, okay. My love, my darling.
This goes down to the wheel like that. Okay? You've got a foot pedal which accelerates the wheel.
Of course you do.
Okay.
All right.
So that's down to the middle to get the ice cream out.
Okay.
Bigger blow.
Got him?
Yep.
So many jokes, but not for daytime. Not for daytime.
And now you put your elbow on there.
Yeah.
Keep the wheel going slowly.
Yeah.
Make sure the ice cream is right into the middle.
See.
Yep.
Very nice.
Okay. And then to make a bowl.
I love
down
the way that looks.
Yeah.
I don't know why. I don't
move that out.
With this being television, are we meant to keep talking?
We're all just bored. That's
incredible, though. Eh?
Pull out
yeah.
the bowl.
David is the world's only ice cream potter.
It's very there you go.
No pressure, okay. No pressure.
Then just yeah. to clean off the bottom a little bit.
Oh, yeah. You've got to be looking at, all right?
Don't take this the wrong way, Gino, but I reckon and you've then. Got about as much chance of doing this as flying to the moon. Why?
Brilliant. Right, it's your turn, Gino. Flipping out. Get in the seat. Just, do you want to have a little fiddle and see if
see
it feels nice?
Oh, that is very smart, though. Look, little few
yeah,
berries
beautiful.
In these.
Huh? What are these?
Blackberries.
That's blackberries.
They're
big blackberries.
Big ones, aren't they?
Yeah. Yeah. Do you know we've got a bumper blackberry crop because we had hot weather in March and then it went cold, so there's less fruit, but there's the same area
farm?
Of leaves.
Where do you come up with all this stuff? On the radio yesterday.
All right.
Gino, there is your
yeah.
funnel.
All right, so Gino, you have mold. Got a minute to make an ice cream pot, all right? So get it on the wheel.
You want to get it centred?
Somewhere, yeah. the Tin Man from The Wizard of Oz is about to get rather excited.
Go on, Gina.
Do you want it? You
show him his box.
Show it first. Can we have a minute on the clock, please?
Put some more in.
All right, there it is. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, go!
Come on, Gina! Gino, that is not what you are meant to be making!
Come on, Gino, stop picking him out. Come on. I knew you were going to do that, Gino.
Oh,
it's not bad.
Wobbly, wobbly. It's not bad, though, eh?
That's all right, that.
Use your thumb, use your thumb.
Oh, no.
Use your thumb.
Very good. I think quit while you're ahead, Gino.
Your elbows down.
Oh, he must have stopped the wheel.
See, of course, your son was done perfectly, but how do you take this one off?
With the wire?
Yeah, slice it. Yeah, like a cheese slicey thing.
One sec, if I can get this wire to work. So you push it underneath, right?
Yeah.
Push it underneath, that's it. All right, and then you pick it up?
Yep. Ooh. That's it, just slide it up, yeah.
That's amazing, well done!
See, your son is going to be flat.
This one's got pretty melted, isn't it? So yours looks really good.
Yeah, it looks brilliant.
Not
that's
bad.
So good. Guys, thank you very much for coming in.
Nice ice cream.
Thank you. And Charlie, thank you
very
so much.
Thank you.
Tom Francis and David Jones, everybody. Thank you, guys.
Okay,
you're coming up, which dish have you chosen for Gino to cook? Will it be the chicken korma or the ultimate cheeseburger? Find out right after this.
But before that, I'm taking a short break with an ice cream. Wales has a tasty tradition of ice cream manufacturers and is renowned for its exclusive scoops. I'm heading to Pembroke Dock to the ice cream laboratory that is taking it to a different stratosphere. So here I am, in the right place, an ice cream factory to meet a West Walian Willy Wonka. Hello there, hi.
Hello, nice to meet you, Connie.
It's not Willy, is it?
It's not Willy, no, it's Charlie.
It's Charlie, even better, Charlie and the ice cream factory. And it is quite an ice cream factory.
It's all right, isn't it?
Charlie Francis grew up in an ice cream family in Pembrokeshire. He's taken the tradition a step further, and he's got a fetish for fantastical flavours like toast and marmalade, roast beef and horseradish, and dark port and Stilton. His trick is to use liquid nitrogen to freeze fresh ingredients in seconds.
I can use fresh ice cream mix and any number of ingredients, put it into the pot, and make ice cream fresh in about a minute.
Ice cream in a minute? For this, we need something you may not have in your kitchen at home. Safety glasses. Turn on the liquid nitrogen.
Basically, to make ice cream, you need two things. You need agitation, which is your mixing.
Agitation.
And then the second thing we need is your cold. You need your freezing. So we're going to turn on the liquid nitrogen now.
All the way?
Yep, pull them up. Pull them up all the way. And that's the liquid nitrogen coming out there.
I feel like I'm in a science lab. Back at school again.
Should I hold my breath or something?
No, it's fine. Okay. You should just...
What is liquid nitrogen, then?
Liquid nitrogen is basically... it's nitrogen, which makes 80% of the air we breathe. So it's a common gas. It's been compressed. It turns into a liquid, right? And at that point, it's incredibly cold. So it's minus 193 degrees centigrade when it's coming out of there. And it's freezing the ice cream almost instantly. There you go, fresh ice cream.
Et voilà.
Dive into that.
Man, that is so good.
It's all right, isn't it?
I meant that. Well, you meant that.
Look at you taking all the credit. You've turned on me.
Made in a minute, eaten in seconds. But Charlie said we can make ice cream from anything. So how'd you fancy lamb and mint sauce ice cream with a hint of rosemary? A good Welsh dish.
That's nice. Lamb and mint ice cream.
Is it?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's do it.
All right. Chop that up like really nice and fine now. So we get almost like we want lamb shard, I think would be nice in this. And then we can add them as a ripple.
Okay.
Let's start with the ice cream. Right.
Okay.
So let's put about a loaded teaspoon of that delicious mint sauce in there as well. about number two. Mix that round, and then your right hand...
On the liquid nitrogen,
not that one, the other one. That one. The world will end if you do that one. That's the takeoff. The whole thing starts to fly.
Right, okay.
Yeah. And let's just get lots of liquid nitrogen there, nice and getting all lovely and cold.
Check the lamb in now.
We'll chuck that in and we'll freeze it. And then I think that should be lamb and mint ice cream. Let's put a bit on there.
Look at the rosemary as well.
That's amazing.
Something that cool. So we go.
It's interesting. It's different. And it hands down beats vanilla.
The rosemary really works.
God, doesn't it?
Do you think you could put that on your menu?
Absolutely.
Yes!
Yeah, come on! Connie's lamb and mint.
Woo! Connie's lamb and mint.
Done.
Love it. I'm on a roll. Connie's exclusive Welsh scoops. Cowl and daffodil, leek kink of Philly cheese, bara brith and lava bread. Makes you proud to be Welsh. I'm spending the day...
Now, for a West Country world first, it involves ice cream, liquid nitrogen and, yes, a potter's wheel.
A year ago, Charlie Francis won a business prize for his instant on-the-spot ice cream machine. I think we had him in here. And today he decided to push back the frontiers of frozen food.
Yes, our business correspondent Dave Harvey has the story.
A contraption worthy of Willy Wonka. Charlie and his amazing ice cream factory. Mix ripe berries with West Country milk and cool super fast with liquid nitrogen at 190 degrees below zero.
And for the Queen's Jubilee, we have a frozen eaten mess made with fresh strawberries and crushed up meringue.
So you got your wacky ice cream, but you want to do more now?
Yeah, I think we should do something different with ice cream. So I met this wonderful chap called David Jones recently, who's a ceramic potter. And I said to him, wouldn't it be nice if we could try and throw an ice cream pot?
What, a pot made out of ice cream?
A pot made out of ice cream, exactly.
Why?
I think mainly because no one's ever done it before, and I think that's a good enough reason.
And in Dave Jones' experienced hands, the ice cream bowl takes shape. Well, kind of.
That ice cream is melting very quickly on the top now.
Time for a little more liquid nitrogen then, and gradually a new kind of pottery is born.
And this is the really nice thing about using this stuff, because you can change the consistency of it as you work with it. Excellent. I think that's as much as I could do with that ice cream, actually. It's very good indeed.
What do you reckon, Charlie?
I think it's brilliant. Absolutely perfect. The nicest bowl I've ever seen in my life. And it's edible.
Edible bowls.
Edible bowls.
Fantastic.
Very good.
But they're not done yet. Remember, these are food artists pushing back the frozen frontier with a ring of cameras.
3, 2, 1.
The ultimate freeze frame.
The ice cream is melting, so we're doing a 3D capture, capturing this from a full 360 degrees, so we can then turn that into a computer model, make real bowls out of that.
You know, what we've seen today, I feel privileged to be here, to be honest, is the coming together of creativity, art and technology, and that's the great British spirit, you know, innovation. And it's innovation which will get us through this this recession, really, and is the mark of a great British company. Mm.
It's actually really nice.
Dave Harvey, BBC Points West, with the ice cream artists of Corsham.